Where can they be?
The ball is tonight. They must have taken the invitations with them. You wouldn't happen to have seen two carriages pass by here just now?
I did, sir. One with a man in it, the other with a woman. They split up.
Where did the man go?
That way.
Thank you.
Future Prime Minister!
How do you do?
Sir, an honor.
Thank you for your continued support.
I salute you, sir.
William Gladstone, your service.
outmatched.
We need more moralizing in modern politics.
Indeed we do. Madam, what a lovely dress.
Thank you.
I look forward to serving as your future Prime Minister. What a turnout!
Indeed, it is splendid.
It is my honor to represent you in power.
I don't think he wants to be disturbed.
Up to any mischief.
Keep your eyes peeled for any antics.
Odd fellow.
Not much of a hiding spot if we can see him.
Not get near him.
Wonder what he's up to.
Does he need help?
What on earth are you doing?
Your Prime Minister, I will fight for your freedom. Freedom from the vices of alcohol and rowdy pubs.
Prime Minister.
How do you do?
Sir, an honor.
Thank you for your continued support.
He's a strange one, isn't he?
I salute you, sir.
William Gladstone, at your service.
What's he lurking about for?
Maybe I haven't been quite as delicate as I could have been. But still. Mrs. Gladstone's under guard. Better be cautious. Better wait until she's alone. Now is my chance. One should not attend the Queen's ball without making a proper entrance.
If you ask me. Having a bit of fun, is he?
Now for the invitations. What's this? Swords must be left at the door by order of the Queen. Freddy will know what to do. Doing fine, girl. That's the way. Now. Keep moving. That's a girl.
What carriage you got there? Where did you buy it, if you don't mind me asking?
Ask all you want, Freddy. You'll never get an answer.
Damn it all. Was it my eyebrows?
Yes. And your face, voice, and body. Look, I've got an invitation to the Queen's ball tonight.
How did you come by that?
Freddy, there's to be an attack on the ball. I need to smuggle some weapons inside to prevent it.
Supposing I believe you? Only the Royal Guard carries weapons.
So?
Too easy.
For God's sake, Freddy.
Fine. I require a guard's uniform.
Done. I knew you'd come through.
Just promise me, Jacob, that you will return Mr. Gladstone's coach.
Of course.
I wonder if his mind is affected. What in the world is he doing? Interesting choice of location. People can see you, you know.
Charming. Now to hide the body.
An interesting choice of location. world is he doing?
Please step away. You're not allowed in.
What happened here?
No.
An interesting choice of location.
On we go.
Ready? Here I come. One uniform as requested.
It's still warm.
My gift to you?
I will meet you on the roof of Buckingham Palace.
You're such a romantic.
Delighted to see you again, Miss Fry.
Your Highness, the plans detailing the renovations to Buckingham Palace have gone astray.
I suppose you will have to make do with the copies.
There are copies? Where?
Not so fast. First, I have a matter of some urgency. Carrying out my plan would require stealth and speed, qualities I know you possess.
Time is of the essence, Your Highness.
Then make this quick, my dear. The most influential men in Parliament remain beyond my reach. But these very men have sent for carriages to prepare for the ball tonight. Acquire an official carriage, and we shall drive the politicians to their destinations. Along the way, I will meet with them. And afterward, I shall tell you where to find the plans.
You're a shrewd negotiator.
One must be when one is so often underestimated.
Don't allow personal feelings to compromise the mission. What a mistake.
I need your skills, Dido.
What'd you get?
We have an important job to do.
With a pile of shit. Draw and shoot!
Someone's made it in here!
Shoot!
You leave me no choice! Out!
My God! Did I do something? I'm sorry.
I should probably get out of the way.
Yeah.
That's it. Climb up, Your Highness. Where are we headed?
Belgrave Square.
Anticipating my arrival.
Welcome, sir.
Your Highness, what a surprise.
Is life not about embracing the unexpected? I shall take but a few moments of your time. A matter of utmost importance must be discussed. When the Commonwealth seized the Punjab from my people.
It was not a seizure, but a rightful transaction.
Britain promised to protect me. By robbing me of my kingdom, Parliament acted in violation of the treaty signed with my family. Here, read it.
I was not aware.
Read. That is all I ask. You are one of the few in a position to help.
I will do what I can.
Thank you, sir.
Roll there. Come on!
I trust you and your son will enjoy the ball this evening.
He is newly returned from Delhi. I will share what we have discussed. It is most disconcerting.
That proved quite valuable.
Where to now?
St. James's Park. I noticed Mr. Green did not accompany you.
He has other things to attend to.
Ah, a pity. You two seem to get along nicely.
Well, that was a problem, you see. One must not allow personal feelings to compromise one's mission.
That sounds like a quotation.
It is. From my father.
Ethan Fry.
You knew him?
No, unfortunately. But Mr. Green spoke of him. He sounded like an extraordinary man.
He was, Your Highness.
And your mother as well, Cecily Fry. She and your father were partners, inseparable. The only duo that came close to challenging Mr. Starrick. And very much in love, at least from the small amount I have been told.
Cecily. I wish I could have met her.
From what Mr. Green gathered, you share much in common. Your intelligence, for one.
Father never spoke of her. What would Mr. Green know? He was only a boy when he talked with my father.
Children can be quite perceptive, Miss Fry.
Ruben, come on!
Hold them.
To Parliament, please, on the double.
Yes, sir.
Good day, sir.
Why, what are you doing here, Your Highness?
I know how busy your days have been of late. A few moments of your time is all I require.
This is all rather unorthodox, but continue.
Britain was to protect me according to the treaty my family signed. Instead, she took my land. And now I hear Britain intends to strengthen her ties to India. Perhaps it is time to return the Punjab to her people.
The Queen has supplied you with an annual income for God knows how long, and now you bite the hand that feeds you?
It is not a matter of money. I cannot stand idle and watch my homeland subjected to the yoke of an outsider's...
Good day, sir.
May God bless you. Only one more remains. To the Gladstone residence.
Do you miss India?
I remember that my mother smelled of cinnamon. And when she cradled me in her arms in the summer heat, I would hold so still that she fell asleep. When I lost my kingdom, it hurt.
But... The Cinnabian Club, straight away!
Good day, Mr. Gladstone.
Mr. Singh!
You are a hard man to pin down.
I know what this is about. Your parlor tricks have worn off. Your Majesty is tired of you. So now you come begging for scraps.
You wound me deeply, sir. My people deserve freedom. I am here to fight for them.
Why did you lose the Punjab? I shall tell you, Your Highness. You were outgunned, outmaneuvered, and simply outclassed. Yes, the Sikhs deserve freedom. I hope with British help and progress, they shall achieve it.
Then why do they cry out to their king?
Britain has a duty to bring about peace. It is an enormous responsibility, and I value your guidance and advice. Along much luck, Your Highness, with your lobbying. I hope my advice has done some good.
Far more than your policies thus far. But I hold out hope that you will make progress. My people are counting on it.
Thank you, Miss Fry, for forwarding my cause.
Oh, you are welcome. I hope some good comes of it, despite Mr. Gladstone's vitriol.
Those of us with the largest hearts protect them the most. Your father, for instance. From what I understand, he was extraordinarily sad, broken even, after your mother's passing. That kind of pain can blind us, cause us to say outlandish things to protect the ones we love. It's time you returned this carriage and recovered those plans. They are located in Buckingham Palace. The Queen keeps them among her personal papers in the White Drawing Room. I wish you a good evening, Miss Evie Fry.
And to you, Your Highness.
Good day, dear Miss Fry.
Our first stroke!
Intruder! Alarm! Better keep an eye on her.
Plum gates! Is it Christmas already, my fine Christina?
What's the problem here? You're
making my mouth travel with the red and the
blood of the church!
Of course he'd arrive in that.
Miss Fry?
Hand him your weapons. We must enter unarmed. Go on in, sir and madam. Without
cards. Dear madam, I am soon to become prime minister.
What in the blazes is our carriage doing here?
Did I hear something?
No, just the voices in your own head.
And yet, they are so much more pleasant than yours.
Charming.
Aren't I?
I shall go and find the Peace of Eden.
As you wish. I'm off to meet Freddy.
The plans are located in the white drawing room, which is most likely locked. The captain of the guard will have a key. And this will be over before you know it.
Who are you? Gentle. Gentle. Gentle.
Brigands
up to now. My arm!
The lady is with me.
Much obliged.
Madam? Gentle! My arm!
Pleasant dreams. The plans are somewhere nearby. Now for the vault. Jacob's most likely off stealing another carriage somewhere, or accidentally pushing the Queen down a flight of stairs. There you are! I have someone I'm simply dying for you to meet. Come with me! Your Majesty, may I present Miss Evie Fry?
You are the one responsible for Mr. Gladstone's mishap.
Your Majesty, I apologize.
The cake is particularly good. Enjoy the ball.
I really must be going.
Miss Fry, may I have this dance?
Mr. Starrick, you've had your fun, but the game is over.
Listen. One, two, three. One, two, three. Time is a wonderful thing, Miss Fry. It heals all wounds. We may make mistakes while dancing, but the mazurka ends, and then we begin again. Problem is, everyone forgets. They trip on the same mistakes over and over.
People can learn.
Can they? Isn't everyone around you repeating the same steps? But if one man could remember the dance, could know the time, then he could change things for the better.
I have had enough.
This dance is nearly over. Soon, the people will forget the generation on this terrace. The ruin you nearly wrought on London. When the music ceases, Miss Fry, your time is up.
Congratulations. Starek peppered the regulars with his own men and took several guards hostage. Your weapons are in there.
Look.
Right. I'll kill the imposters and rescue the captives.
It's impossible to tell the difference.
Oh, ye of little faith. Now to find the real royal guards.
Thank you.
I come over there!
Finished here. Hold still for a moment.
You have my thanks.
Thanks, mate.
Thank you all.
The key to the waltz is one must lead with one's right foot.
Oh, my!
Everything all right, my dear?
Do you require assistance?
I never liked balls. Here, the location of the vault. Go!
Just like that?
No plan?
No time for plans. I'll catch up as soon as I'm rid of this infernal contraption.
Exploiting. I warned you, my boy, but you do not listen.
Requies Carton Pace.
Let me rectify my mistake.
Thank you.
city.
London will perish without me.
You flatter yourself.
I would have created a paradise.
The city belongs to the people. You are but one man.
I am at the very top of the order.
You were, Mr. Starrick. You were.
Shame we won't be partners anymore.
It's for the best, isn't it?
Are you gonna wear the shroud and run London?
Whatever it gives, it takes from someone else. You'd continue to age without me. You'd become like father.
A fate worse than death.
Will you wear it?
After you sorted out the boroughs, the chaos I caused, I couldn't compete.
Jacob Fry stepping back. Who's blackmailing you? Is it George?
He wouldn't dare. I've missed you.
Me too. Would it be possible to continue where we left off?
I'd love nothing more.
I'm starting to think Father didn't know everything about everything. Henry.
It's a big world out there. With London in the center.
Perhaps not the very center.
I came as soon as I could. Do not worry. I'll head back to the train. Did I jeopardize the mission?
Henry, you saved it. I think you belong in the field with me.
A carriage! Nicely done, Freddy.
Mr. Abeline, please.
Your Majesty.
Miss Fry.
You've met before?
Did I never mention?
Mr. Abeline informs me that you three are responsible for saving my life. Is this true?
It is, Your Majesty.
Evie Fry, step forward. And you?
My brother, ma'am. Jacob Fry. And this is Mr. Henry Green.
Mr. Fry? Mr. Green? Kneel. I invest you all in the Order of the Sacred Garter.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
If you are as adept as Mr. Abeline implies, I may call on you.
Sergeant Abeline tends to exaggerate, Your Majesty.
We shall meet again. And Miss Fry?
Ma'am?
Should you want it? I saved you some cake.
Father would be proud of you.
Dame Evie Fry.
Sir Jacob Fry.
Race you to the train.
You're on.
That's it. It's under the palace.
Time to go. Let's get the shroud to Dr. Grammatica immediately.
Sigma team beat us here. We're too late.
What do we do?
Killing really is the least productive way to achieve our goals. Kill them all.
Leave them
contact!
Cover me! That skinny piece of shit tried to murder me, Berg. I want him them to bleed. Whispered dreams that poisoned
us. Them that told us lies of their bravery. Them that preached of progress and put us in the poorhouse. Them done the horrid murder on bloody stages. Them that loudly crowed their humility. Lords and lady that sung in the chapels on a Sunday. All quiet now, their mouths are stopped up.
Hold still, goddammit!
They lie flung in rocks and make no sound.
Only the mission matters!
Understood!
Those who fought
Sean!
Something better. Those who taught by how they live. Loved ones taken long before their word.
Galena, we need an exit!
Righteous.
We need to go. Now.
Understood. The shroud.
Forget the bloody shroud. Stay with me, Bex. Please.
We go.
Good work in there, Initiate. In time, we will recover the shroud. And hey, we pulled a feed from our bug in Isabel's computer before they shut us out. Playing it now.
Sorry about the mess.
So, how's the Shroud gonna help you create a new clone?
It's not. When the Shroud is wrapped around the body, it scans it for damage and then reconstructs it on a cellular level.
You're not making a clone. You're gonna recreate a precursor from scratch.
Bingo! The Phoenix Project timetable just got accelerated big time. I'm going to call Alan Rickon and deliver the good news. It's like Christmas!
Hello? It's me? Brought the Shroud as you asked, but I'm scared.
Do not fear me. You've done well.
I'm not scared of you. I'm scared for you. Anyone finds out what you've been doing.
You have played your part, my instrument. I will save you. I will save you all.
dressed in sartorial splendor. I hope you've sharpened.
Message of hope, perfection. A red tulip.
A declaration of love. I, Miss Rye, you know that I hold you in the highest esteem and regard, and I was wondering if you would do me the honor, if you would give me your hand in matrimony.
Yes.
Knight of the realm? Don't make me laugh.
Thank you.
my newly honored friends?
Your Majesty.
We understand that with Crawford Starrick gone, a certain secret society finds itself searching for leadership. An upstart faction seeks to enter London and seize power.
Do you feel your life is in danger, ma'am?
No. Rather, I fear that the people of this grand city may suffer. I call upon you to foil this traitorous plot.
You can depend on us.
You will meet my loyal aide at the docks for instructions. Your work begins immediately.
I am Elfrid Fleming. I run Her Majesty's Secret Service. First things first, we need to... Fine, girl. Steady on. Agents are here, disguised as civilians. Get them into position for our ambush. A ship will soon arrive from Boston. Its cargo? Its crew? Templar. What say you to greeting it with an ambush?
I'd say we're going to be very good friends.
Let's wreak havoc, shall we?
Yes, go.
Tell me something.
Just let the Ark and help.
Why don't we pick off a few blighters?
Blighter.
Shoot!
Now! Fire!
Don't get away, you rats!
You're dead!
Off you go.
That's their leader. I want him brought to me at the station, alive.
Jacob?
I don't suppose you'd care to confess.
Go to hell!
Fair enough.
Steric may be dead and gone, but the Templar Order will never die. We will rise again, like a phoenix from the ashes, and bring the world to its knees.
Not exactly Grandmaster material, are you?
People are recovering their explosive cargo. You did fine work today. I will have a chat with our distinguished guest here to see what schemes he and his friends are brewing.
Do get in touch when he spills his guts.
Of course.
Fleming has attempted to force a confession from your prisoner. The miscreant refuses to talk. Will you speak to the villain and learn his secrets?
Oh, I'd be delighted, Mom.
tease you to bits!
I don't suppose you'd like to spare yourself a tremendous beating and make a clean breast of it.
Might as well. The order was to load a train with explosives at Westminster. It'll detonate before reaching Southwark Station and kill everyone aboard.
I did not expect you to confess. Which train?
It's the next train. It should leave at any moment.
You'll never make it in time.
Yeah.
Lamented husband adored these gardens. He called them his one safe port in the midst of the mad seas of this world. We miss him dearly. But never mind all that. To business. Our Mr. Fleming has learned from the Templar prisoner that an attack is imminent. But before we could learn more, he escaped custody. He is believed to be hiding in Westminster. Recapture him for us, that we might learn his secrets.
Slippery devil. To the rest of the group. That's the way.
See the lion's sails.
Keep moving.
Lion's sails and greatest deals. Deep discounts on all essential goods and services.
I'm going on ahead to scout the location. Bring these explosives to the safe house and wait for my signal.
I need to get these explosives away from the civilians. I'll deal with the Templar later.
Yeah.
Crazed Templars. That will be all.
The final group of upstarts are making their last desperate stand. They have penetrated the Houses of Parliament and plan to detonate whatever explosives they have left. Please find Mr. Fleming, so we might put an end to this once and for all.
Multiple.
Require a reason to end your life.
This neighborhood is falling apart. Even the people are turning into animals. The beasts in the courts are an injury of bed.
See?
Embarrassing.
Sure, you understand. Can't do anything about it.
Dodge, I should punish.
You see a
original guy.
He's stark raving mad. He don't know if he's hiding a spy.
Mr. Fleming, I've located the Prime Minister.
Not another step, assassin. You've lost, don't you see? The Houses of Parliament are rigged to explode at the last stroke of 12.
There's nothing you or anyone else can do to stop it now. The Houses of Parliament will be leveled. Centuries of history are going to be blown away in a second.
No point shooting ourselves any further.
Find those balls! Find those bombs before they go off!
Thank you.
Thank you, my young friend. Now, please come with me. You and your sibling have been summoned.
Approach.
You have honored us with your loyalty and courage. Long may we strengthen the Empire together.
Your Majesty, we will always work to ensure the safety of the people.
But with the greatest respect, our philosophy forbids us from assisting with the expansion of the Empire. Perhaps, ma'am, you could consider putting an end to your imperialist desires.
I understand and respect your position. Bound as you are by your creed, you will indulge me one final time, and receive these gifts. Goodbye, and may God bless the noble fries.
I suppose you'll be offered any more cake.